Hi everyone, welcome to Lazen's Tips. I'm Alessia. Today I want to talk to you about calories and why it's a waste of time to count calories while you're trying to lose weight. Keep on watching, keep on listening, and let's get into this. The calories question is something that I get asked pretty much every day. The common questions are, how many calories does this exercise burn? How many calories do I need to burn throughout the day? How many calories do I need to eat in order to get that ballerina fit shape that I really wanted? But let's start with common sense. Let's say that a bowl of French fries, 100 grams of French fries, super fried, they've got salt, they pretty much have no vitamins or minerals or anything that you need to make us run better, and their calories are about 300 calories. Talking about fats and good fats, a avocado with toast, whole grain toast, it's rich in vitamins, it's rich in good fats and rich in fibers, so it gets you going, and it's around 390 calories. So let's ask that question, which one is gonna make me feel full? Which one is gonna make me feel better? Common sense, here we go. So of course you're not gonna go for the fatty, yucky French fry, but you're gonna go for something good. And I perfectly know that going for comfort food is gonna be the best thing. It's gonna make you feel so rewarded. Sugar, it makes you feel good. It's the energy thing without the energy. But then you're left with nothing. Imagine running a car. You pour gasoline in it, right? Perfect. But let's say we want to pour a drop of plutonium in it. The car is definitely not gonna run any faster. The car will definitely explode. Unless you're Doc Brown and you're building a car that is gonna go back to the future. Same thing with our body. We are a complicated machine that needs the right fuel to function. So now I really want to get into why you should stop counting calories from now. Number one, be sensible. No one is telling you to not have pizza, but if you're trying to lose weight, of course you're not gonna have it every day. Make it as your reward. You can have it once a month. It can be the satisfying thing after you achieved your goal at the end of the month. You always have to consider what you put into your body. If you want to feel more energetic, of course you're not gonna eat pizza, because all the carbs and everything that is topped on it is gonna turn into sugars, and it's gonna turn into making you feel bloated and making the machine run much slower. So no one is saying don't have it, but be sensible when you're having it. It has to be your reward. Number two, don't be tempted. When you're going to the supermarket is gonna be full of junk food. They're gonna have pretty packages, they're gonna have pretty things just catching your eyes. And guess what? The supermarkets have got a fantastic tactic to make you buy what they want. And most of the times are the unhealthy food. Have you ever noticed that everything that they want you to buy is at eye level? Anything that is healthy, it's cheaper, it's good for you, they're actually hidden either on top of the shelves or down the bottom. Because what they want is for you to see colorful packaging, so you're gonna go for those. And remember, there is one question that you need to ask yourself. Is this good for me? Supermarkets are gonna make money out of what we buy. And it's easier for them to actually sell you something that is unhealthy. So the other question is, will you want to put that into your body? Is this pack of cookies gonna make me feel better? For how long? Remember, don't be tempted. And every time you look at a pretty packaging, you're not gonna win my health. Number three, watching what you intake after your exercise. If you are exercising, you will definitely burn calories. And of course, we need more to burn more. I don't know you, but when I finish exercising, I want to eat a lot although you can't really see it. And my first thing is I want to bite someone's arm as how hungry I am. Think about that bowl of fries. It's definitely not gonna help you to rebuild muscle fibers, because that's what you need to do. And that's what the proteins do. They rebuild the muscles inside our body. We don't know, but there is little man going inside our body to actually rebuild the whole fibers of the muscles. You need to rehydrate the muscles, because you sweat, you work, there is a lot of oxygen going around everything, and you get dehydrated. Everything needs to be replaced. But a bowl of fries or a toast with Nutella, which, by the way, a teaspoon of Nutella is about 80 calories, between 80 and 90 calories, one teaspoon, is definitely not gonna do that for your body. Do you think that a bowl of fruit with yogurt or something that's gonna be better? Pretty much the same amount of calories. So again, it's changing that mindset of what's good for you and what's not good for you. So think about what you put in before you work out and what you put in after you work out. Remember, those little peeps rebuilding everything that inside our body, they need the right tools to actually put it together. And that brings you back to point one, be sensible. Number four, stop obsessing about food. The more you think about calories, the more you think about food, the more you think about food, the more it's gonna stay in your head constantly. And if that is the case, you're definitely not gonna enjoy life. If you're strict at only counting calories, it's exhausting. It becomes a mind game. You're a slave of those numbers and everything that you do based on the food calories. You don't enjoy life, you don't enjoy your time, and especially you don't enjoy eating. Enjoying food is important. It's very important. The only thing that we need to do is to change that mindset and recognizing what is good for us and what is bad for us. You need to know exactly that colorful and fresh fruit is definitely going to be better than processed food where it's got calories, bad fat, and carbohydrates, which carbs are very good for you, by the way, don't take it wrong. But it's how it's going to make us feel, is the energy level and what the intake for this complicated machine is going to be. So again, it's only our mindset that needs to be changed to get rid of all that crappy food that is out there and that we don't need. So think about that. Bowl of fruit, toast with Nutella. Which one are you going to take to lose weight? Number five, get rid of the guilt, enjoy eating real, and move. You need to stop feeling guilty about the numbers. You need to know that exercising and eating well are gonna take you to the desired goal. They're gonna shape that body the way you want it. Exercising and eating well must be complementary to each other. And remember that if you're stuck with anything that you need to do, I'm gonna link down below my top 5 secrets on how to be ballerina fit. If your body feels good, your energy level increases, you've got more energy. If you eat well and exercise, your metabolism starts activating. It becomes a very happy, vicious circle that once you start, you can't get rid of. So get rid of that guilt of counting numbers. Start exercising, move around, and feel good. And you're probably saying, I don't have time. I'm probably gonna start doing something at some point. I'm gonna do exercise. I'm not ready to diet. But hang on, I haven't said to start a diet. I haven't said to deprive yourself of your happy food. I haven't said to stop eating or not eating anything bad. You can do that every now and then. But again, it's changing the mindset on how to be good to yourself. It's a very, very small change of attitude towards how you see food. And even if you have a busy life, there are things out there that you can choose. You've got plenty of options. It's only up to you to decide how you want to feel. I can't do that for you. I don't have a magic wand that goes, now you're gonna eat well, now you're gonna feel fantastic, now you're gonna exercise. Unfortunately, that's something that we need to do for ourselves, and it's something that needs to be pushed. It's our mindset, how much we want it, and how much we're gonna go for it. So I really hope you're ready for this, and I really hope you're gonna take this step to a better you, a new you, and a better healthy lifestyle. Stop counting calories now. Mwah.